Okay, welcome friends to the third module. As I said in the previous module, in these three modules we are going to actually overview, take the overview of the entire networking system. In the third module, this particular module, we are going to see how an actual application like mail application and a web page download application, HTTP application, takes place. Okay, so let us try to see. This is a development team and these are our learning objectives. We start talking about the mail or SMTP protocol. Here we have this is the client, okay, and this is the mail server, and we are going to talk about how that happens. Okay, let us start with an example. There is a mail to be sent to bs3vedi@glsuniversity.ac.in. The first part before at is known as mailbox. The rest glsuniversity.ac.in is called a domain name. What these things are, we will see later actually, well, when we talk about DNS. But this, you probably have seen hundreds of mail addresses, every email address is of this type. So, what does this do? The SMTP client running on your laptop or mobile phone or whatever gets the IP address of the glsuniversity.ac.in using something called DNS. We will not be discussing about how DNS do that job, but we will see that later. Okay, and use that IP address in connecting to the mail server, and once that is done, you can see that the glsuniversity.ac.in servers contain some folders called BS Trivedi, VN Nagauri, JB Trivedi and PN Patel. So, these are folders or mailboxes, and this is delivered to BS Trivedi folder because it is said so, okay. So, it is part of the mailbox, it is part of the mail address, okay. And remember this model that we have already looked at before, the sender, receiver and two routers, intermediary routers, and we will continue with this model. As I said, the model is same for multiple routers as well, it is not going to be changed much. Okay, the first thing, transport layer processing. Remember, DNS provides IP address to the client. Now, we are talking about that mail process, please understand. But before we jump into exact mail process, we will see the first thing, what it does. It DNS provides IP address to the client, what the IP address of glsuniversity.ac.in. Our mail client requests the TCP process to establish connection with the IP address, okay. So, that you can see senders and TCP receiver, and the connection is established once this thing is done. And once the connection establishes, it provides a very, very important value called port number. Now, because it is a mail client, would like to talk to mail server. It is possible that the physical server running at the other end might contain multiple servers running, okay. So, it might have mail, telnet or FTP, and all three of them are running, okay. So, what is a port number? The port number is a separate number for each service designated, okay, and normally all designers use the same value, okay. So, this mail is delivered to this port number 25, telnet is delivered to port number 23, FTP is delivered to port number 20. Okay. The server knows whenever something is received at 25, will deliver to mail server. Something which is received at 23 is given to telnet server. Something which is received at 20 will be given to FTP server. So, this is the first thing that happens. What happens next? Remember this, now the mail is to be sent. So, that mail content is given to the packet. So, what? So, TCP generates something called connection request. Remember, this is connection oriented, so it has to generate and give it to IP, okay. So, it can start processing further, okay. So, IP processes at the sender, looks at the destination IP. We have already seen that it has to look at the destination IP and then send it across, okay. With help of routing tables, it will route that thing to next immediate, eventually to the receiver, okay. We have a sender and we have a typical mail server. So, you can see that the packet goes through through first frame, second frame, third frame and the server. This is already seen, okay. Now, we are elaborating this a bit. You can see that with every router you have some routing table. Though we have seen identical routing tables here because they are just shown for demonstration. In fact, there are multiple ways to have specific routing tables, okay. We have already hinted about it and we will be looking at later, okay. Now, we have seen that SMTP is that application layer, TCP, IP and last two are any, okay. Let us try to see what happens at each layer. Sender generates, gives a TCP segment and that is known as segment part and that happens at transport layer or TCP. The TCP segment is given to IP, it adds IP header. Now, it is called a packet, okay. Address resolution process takes place. Address resolution is very important. We'll see soon see what's the job of it. It is given to the data link layer. Now, data link layer is part of the network interface card. Okay, this thing is called a frame, and this frame is given to. In fact, it is still part of the network interface card, but moves from data link to physical layer, and it is sent to the receiver. When the receiver receives this frame. Okay, the router's network interface card receives this particular frame. Once it receives, what does it do? You can see that this network interface card contains both physical and data link layer. So, the physical layer converts this thing in form of bits because it received this thing as a signal, it converts that thing into bit and pass it up. And understand the bit stream received as a frame, okay. So, that is a job done by data link layer. It checks the destination address. Okay, it's my address, fine, then I'll process it. Content of the frame is to be passed to the network layer. Now, let us see what the network layer does. The network layer checks the destination address. Okay, looks at the routing table. It now refers to the routing table. It decides where to send this packet. And if it is to be sent to next destination, it decides receiver's MAC address. Now, this is very critical part and this is where you need something called address resolution. You only have an IP address. Now, MAC address is not an IP address. How that is done? We will soon see. Okay. Now, data link layer converts a frame. Okay. Frame contains a header and a trailer and pass back. Now, you can see that this is router's network layer. There is a return journey starts. Okay, so far physical to data link, data link to network, network layer back to data layer, network layer back to now digital layer, this data link layer and then to the physical layer. Okay, now sender's address is a router's own address, receiver's address is a next destination address in the frame itself. Now, please understand the frame contains sender, remember frame 1 is from sender to router 1. So, the sender's address is sender's address, receiver's address is router 1's address. Okay. So, frame contains those addresses, the packet contains sender's as well as the server's address. But so, frames and they are different. Okay. And so, that is the reason why that processing is very critical. And once that is done it is passed to the physical layer. Okay. See the network layer contains, now receives this destination address, okay. Now, the same process you can see that, but then there is a change. It concludes that the network is its own. Now, this is receiver, the web server, okay. So, it passes the content to transport. In the earlier case, it was sent on the return journey, but reverse journey, but now it is not. It is given to the transport layer. Transport layer sends the acknowledgement. Remember, this is something which was very critical. And also, the data is passed up to the application. So, if you have typed a URL, now the web server will receive the URL. But in fact, we are talking about mail case. So, this mail content is passed to the mail server. Okay. So, and the process ends. Okay. So, in the first phase of this module, we have seen an entire journey of a mailing process. Starting from deciding at the sender the port number belong to the mail server, constructing the frame, okay, then obviously the segment, packet and the frame, send it across, and what happens at the intermediary router and what happens at the receiver. We have seen all that phase. We will continue talking about the same in the second phase. We will take a short break. Thank you, friends.